Ladies and gentlemen, muy buenos días a todos. I am Michiel Verwij, Advisor of Water Sanitation and Hygiene at SNV, Netherlands Development Organization in Rwanda. First, I want to thank the organizations Ongangwa and especially Alberto Quijano for giving me the opportunity to share the SNV experience in setting up public-private partnerships in rural water supply in Rwanda. The experience comes from a project implemented in partnership with the Energy, Water and Sanitation Authority and UNICEF from 2009 to 2013. This project included the construction and rehabilitation of water supply, sanitation infrastructure, and also hygiene behavior change. SNV mainly focused on functionality and sustainability of the services. First, let me clarify that I'm talking about the PPP for operation and maintenance, not for the infrastructure investments. Hopefully in the future, users will become more self-reliant to take up also cost for infrastructure. However, for the time being, subsidies from state and donors will still be needed for the initial investment and rehabilitation. SNV, in close collaboration with Energy and Water and Sanitation Authority, has been facilitating the setup of 14 PPP contracts serving over 1 million people in 4 districts. These districts are located in a densely populated fertile volcanic region with rainfall to 1200 millimeters per year. The area carries about 142 water supply systems and over 1500 springs. The pipe systems are mostly gravity fed, but some use pumps to deliver water to the water kiosks and standpipes where it's sold to the consumers. Users pay normally 15 Rwandan francs per jerrycan of 20 liters, which is equivalent to almost 1 euro per cubic meter. The activities led by SNV can be grouped in 3. 1. Making an inventory of the existing systems and water points. 2. Defining the service area, contracts and advising on the procurement process. 3. Training of the operators and raising awareness of the population on the PPP. In our program, we implement, where possible, the National Water and Sanitation Policy. Our vision is to see the PPP model contribute to more sustainable service delivery. It's about putting together the best of the public and the private sector for the well-being of the people. The public sector is important for the social perspective of water as a human right and essential for public health, while the private sector brings in efficient management skills and entrepreneurial approach. Rwanda started implementing the PPP approach in 2004 when it became clear that the community management in water and sanitation in many cases did not work. When a breakdown occurred, the systems were left without repair. This was because many people were not used to pay for water, so it was difficult to raise the money when repairs were needed. The public party in the PPP is the district authority, and the private is in some cases a company and in others a service cooperative. The company that bids for the contract gets a kind of concession to manage the system, mostly for up to 5 years. In return, the company pays a sort of royalty to the district that needs to cover the investments for renewal of the system. The PPP contract outlines the responsibility of district authority and the operator. It ensures there is a water company that can be held accountable for the operation and maintenance of water system, and the district is responsible to deliver a fully functional system, also access road, repairing flood damage, and the bigger rehabilitation are the responsibility of the district. In the past, this was different. Then it was not clear who was the owner and who was responsible for the service. Is it the NGO that built the system or the National Water Authority, or is the community? As soon as the system required a repair, everybody passed the buck. The PPP works well in systems that are robust and with clients that can pay. However, the PPP works less for the remote areas where it's even difficult to attract investors for managing the water supply. In these water systems, sometimes difficult to access, cost recovery is nearly impossible. The response was the design of an inclusive area-based service delivery model. The social objective is to provide all water users with quality maintenance. Within the boundaries of a service area, one can find one, for example, one profitable system, a less profitable system, and also some protected wells at the other side of the mountain. The company would then have a balanced set of clients on a sufficient scale to run a viable enterprise. How were the boundaries established? The National Water Authority preferred to have one professional as finance with strong water provider per district. Well, SMV believed in engaging lots of small providers. This is because the operators do not have the capacity to oversee a large quantity of systems and water points. It is also giving more people a chance to start a business. Finally, a middle ground was achieved through dividing the district in 3 to 4 service areas and an open tendering procedure, giving every player an opportunity to apply and compete. The biggest challenge in implementation has been to make people pay for water. Non-revenue water is a headache for the operators. Initially, there was resistance to install water meters to enable billing for consumption. There was need to install trust in the relation between consumers and the operators. Dialogue was established between the users and operators about calculation of the price of water. The next step is to establish and communicate service standards. Government is creating incentives by making sure the systems are in good shape before handing over, and by promoting low-cost water supply to keep water affordable while maintaining transparent and fair tendering procedures. The Water Authority is also stimulating discussion on water tariffs, and the next step is to include protection of the source and the catchment as well as sanitation in the new PPP arrangements. So what is the key to a successful PPP? Many elements like quality information, clear contracts and joint monitoring are important, but probably the most crucial factor to success is good old principle of involving the stakeholders by giving a voice in the decision-making process, establishing moments for dialogue to learn together for improved service delivery. And finally, where's the place of the NGOs in the PPP story? I believe NGOs still have an added value as neutral players to broker information on technology and management between private and public sectors. Especially in the initial stages, NGOs can assist in social mobilization to organize and create demand for water sanitation hygiene, therefore maximizing impact of the PPP. I want to thank Lambert, the project coordinator from EWASA, Jean-Marie and Gerion from UNICEF, and my SMV colleagues Antoinette, Beatrice, Richard and Rajab for their contribution. Thank you very much, and I hope you have a fruitful continuation of the conference.